Hello everyone, this is Anu from the Australian Academy. The essay that I am going to discuss today is, for a long time, art has been considered an essential part of all cultures in the world. However, nowadays, people's values have changed and we tend to consider science, technology and business more important than arts. That means the value of arts or the creative field or the you can say the innovations in creative side that is taken a backseat and it has been overtaken by science, technology and business fields. So what do you think are the causes of this? That means you have been given a problem and you have to find first of all what are the causes, what are the reasons behind this change and then what can be done to draw people's attention to art? How can you provide a solution to make people prefer art as compared to science, technology and business? Okay, so first of all we will give an introduction like in the current scenario, instead of in the current scenario you can write in the salad days of millennium or in the ultra modern epoch or in the current era or in the contemporary era, the interest of global population. I am trying to paraphrase the question statement by using certain synonyms for the words that are there in the question statement. Global population in art has witnessed a significant decline. Significant decline refers to the loss of interest, like here it is written that there has been a change in the people's values vis-a-vis art and science. Okay, and it has witnessed a significant decline and a paradigm shift is visible towards the science, technology and business. And in this particular essay, I am going to analyze the reasons behind it, why there has been this change, this shift in the taste of the people behind this trend and the justification behind this trend, and also suggest some plausible solutions to boost people's interest in art, because that is what the question asks us to do, that what can be done to initiate the people's interest in art. Okay, this is the introduction part. Then we come to the body paragraph 1, in which we will discuss the causes behind this decline. The first thing that we will start up a passage will be, like you can give a good opening line that there is no iota of doubt, that there is not even a slightest doubt regarding this fact that art promotes creativity and imagination. It is actually pumping up or boosting up the creative side or the imaginative side of a person. But in this modern epoch, in the current time, in the modern times, human beings, they are more dependent on the technology, they are becoming more materialistic, they are focusing on all the gadgets, and the purpose of their thinking or liking is actually based on how well they can or how more they can make their lifestyle luxurious. So arts and creativity and artistic thing, they are taking a backside because that is not actually giving them a luxury. That is like something related to beauty or the aesthetic sense, but people have become so materialistic, they want everything in terms of money or luxury. So there is a change in the taste. Then it is automation and advent of internet. These are the latest technologies due to which the modern fast pace of life is possible these days. It has actually suppressed the creativity. Everybody is creative enough, everybody has got some kind of a dream or a passion, but just because of the fast pace of life due to the advent of internet and then Google and then this automation technology, nobody wants to do anything creative. Then if we talk about the role of the government doesn't patronize these art forms or the art galleries. They do not give enough funds, the budget is not properly allocated for the maintenance or you can say the overall beautification of the art galleries. The artists are not paid their dues, they are not given proper income. It is not a sustainable career option actually. That is why people shy away from pursuing this particular passion or as a career. Then the parents also want their wards to take up science, technology or business fields to be in tandem with the fast pace of modernization. Even if a child is not actually interested, there is a constant push from the parent side that they should take up these kind of, you can say, now the scientific bent of mind is actually thrusted upon the kids who are maybe not interested and they have got a creative side of thing. in their mind. They have a creative liking and they want to pursue their passion. But parents, just because to be in touch, to be in line with the modern fast pace, they are actually making them forcibly to choose this particular career option. So what can be done to make these people who have drifted from the art side towards the scientific? Can we ignore the importance of art? Because we know that arts actually, they represent the rich cultural heritage. They bring out the creativity, they bring out the innovations, they bring out the imaginations one person has, and these actually nurture these inborn talents, these inborn passions a person has. Okay, so when we start the second body paragraph, we can start like, however, I believe that the importance of creative fields cannot be undermined. They are vital for nurturing the talent, the creative abilities of a person, because mostly a person should not be forced to take up any profession. If he has got a flair for painting or maybe something creating new, he should be promoted from all walks of life, be it his parents, be it his school, be it the government or the society as a whole. The expression of art, it helps in overcoming the linguistic barrier. Most of the people, they sometimes face the barrier of expressing their emotions. So art is actually a medium of expressing their emotions. Whatever they cannot express through their words, they try to convey it through their creative side or through these arts and drawing and painting and other creative fields. Okay, so the government should also promote the art galleries. As I discussed before, unless until these things get a green signal from the authorities, they cannot flourish. If the government promotes or advertises these art galleries and they maintain it properly, then obviously this particular sector will also flourish. They should create jobs in the art sector. The artists should be paid handsomely and they should be given due importance and due worth for their work. The schools, how can the schools help? They should, like, you know, they can organize some competitions so as to spark an interest. Unless until a student is shown certain new things, you never know what goes on inside the student, and maybe some people, they have got that particular talent inside, that they are not just getting a via media to express that talent. Because at the end of the day, arts are actually a representation of our rich cultural heritage and they bring out the innovations and the creative side of many a people. So similarly, the parents should also encourage. They should not force them to take up science or business courses only. If a child is actually wanting to pursue something creative, the parents should solidly and healthily promote his interest, and then only this particular art and the interest in art will flourish. So what can be the conclusion? All in all, I would like to conclude that both science and technology in businesses, as well as art and culture, they should coexist, because obviously we cannot undermine the importance of science and technology, nor we can undermine the importance of art and culture. It is just like, due to this fast-paced modernization and new technology, that art and culture has taken a backseat. So we can say that they should coexist, and efforts from all the walks of life, from all sectors, whosoever are connected, they should come together. They should give concerted efforts to nourish and nurture both the fields. Because as we know that if any work is done with the help of science or technology, it is actually done efficiently. But if it is done with the help of art, it actually makes that same work done in a beautiful way. It actually enhances the aesthetic essence of that particular work. Thank you.